Hey, hi. This is a short presentation of my alien pulse rifle that I've recently built. It took about like 3 weeks to make this one. It's essentially based on the Thompson M1A1 and a kit that I got from Airsoft Extreme. The thing is that I didn't want to stay on the classic and simple airsoft version. I wanted to also make something I could use in conventions and also without shooting the plastic bullets, because I wanted the thing to be able to play like custom sounds and things like that, just like my blasters. So I decided to implement an airsoft version plus sound and light effects. And this is what I'm going to show, since most of the rest is on the website in an article described with pictures and everything. So, here's the beast. I've replaced the bad cartridge that went with the kit with something I've machined. I'm not sure it's going to display here, but it's on the website. And I've also decided to add a red dot on the top of the pulse rifle to get something a little bit custom, and also because I like the red dot. I'm probably the only one, but it doesn't matter. So, yeah, the thing is that it's still using some electronics inside, and I decided to keep the same on-off button and system for the battery that came with the kit. So it comes with the little cap here. It's not like in the movie where you get the cap and the and the magazine coming out. So you have to remove both of them separately. So I'm going to power on the device, and you will see that the ammunition counter is starting with zero, like the weapon is not ready. And then you hear the boot sound of my blaster cord that I've modified to make this pulse rifle version. And the boot sound is just the sound that is played when you power on the board. And it can be anything, as usual. And in this case, it's a sort of a mix between fabric and leather sounds plus mechanical sounds like you're going to hear. That's like you... I'm sorry, you take it out and you do something to prepare the weapon, something like that. I'm going to play that again. Oh, power off. So once the boot sound is done, then you have the pulse rifle counter that goes to 95, and it's not doing like the other counters that I've seen on the internet, on which you start at 99 and then you decrease progressively to 95. It's just the stock counter that came with the kit, and I wanted to use everything that came with the kit to see what I could get with without adding money to get some different parts. So this is why I stay on that, and I actually act the internal counter to get it work with my board, so that I can remotely control the inside counter with my board. And this is why, for instance, when I remove the magazine, you get the sound of the magazine removed, and then when you put it back, it goes back to 95. Of course, since it's not very practical to do what I'm doing here, I mean, the weapon is quite heavy, and I'm not a marine, so I decided to cheat a little bit, and I've added a little button that you might see here, if I can, yeah, right here. It's made of rubber, and it's actually faking the removal of the magazine, so that if I want to fake, for instance, to remove the magazine or to show it to someone and explain, then I can simply press the button and release. And it's doing exactly the same as if I was doing that, but in a simple way, so that I can hold a weapon. I have also an additional sound effect, which is pretty nice. It's the shotgun cycling mechanism. And unfortunately, the I think that the limit switch inside has a bit of grease or something like that, so it's not very nicely working for the moment, but you have to do it straight like that. If you open the little window here and you try to pull a trigger, the secondary trigger that is supposed to launch a grenade, then it doesn't work. You have to put it back, and then you can send a grenade. And then if I want to play again, then of course it doesn't work, I have to cycle it again. I have some lights in the front, so I have like a static flash that simulates the launch of the grenade, and I also have like a quickly and rapidly flashing LED just under, I don't know if you see that, maybe this way, it's here, and it's actually giving a visual effect of what the real fire of the pulse rifle is, because with the airsoft that you're going to hear in a minute, of course you have one single shot, and this is going to trigger a sound of the pulse rifle, which is actually a like a multiple shoot. So I decided to make this little flashing thing that helps feeling like you're actually sending a lot of bullets at the same time, just like the pulse rifle is doing. So when I'm doing that, when I will do that, sorry, it goes like that. So if I try to manipulate the trigger without launching an airsoft bullet, just so that you can see it, you can see that. And you can hear also that I have different pulse rifle sounds in there, and they are randomly selected. I have actually 8 different sounds, and it can be a sequence one after the other each time you shoot, or it can be random selection or whatever. So it makes a pretty nice weapon. Of course, you have the thing that is decreasing. Whoops! Out of ammunition. So the inner, the counter, which is internal to my soundboard, is actually the one that is controlling the reset of the counter that came with the kit, so that it stays on 0-0 and it doesn't roll over or whatever. It stays on 0 and it plays the empty sound until you reload the weapon. So here you get a kind of strange noise, like my machine just doesn't work or something like that. So I can still play with the grenade, but if I want to get some ammunition again, then I have to remove the magazine and then I'm able to shoot again. And as I said before, you can still take the thing and using the secret button. So, here we go. I think that's it. Bye.